Hi everyone, welcome to the 21st video on Python learning series for network engineers. In this video, we'll see how to handle device unreachable and device unauthorized exceptions using NetMiko. I'll copy my previous script to the new file 17 NetMiko device exceptions. I'll save the script here. For generating one exception, I'll add IP where device does not exist, 10.10.10.12. I don't have any device in that IP. Now we'll try to execute the script. Python 17. So it is trying to connect to the 12. Yeah, we are getting the error. So exception is NetMiko timeout exception. Connection to the device is timed out. And to handle this error, what you need to do is import the class where this exception is handled, and then you need to use the try and except statement in your script. To see that class, what you need to do is go to pydoc netmiko. Here you can see the class, the same class you will be able to see, NetMiko timeout exception. Yeah, NetMiko timeout exception. You need to import this class. Before we move into that, we will see some simple examples on exceptions, how to handle that. Then we will handle the NetMiko exceptions. So for that, I'll go to my Python interpreter here. Python. I'll create n+1. N is a string and 1 is an integer. If we try to add these two, I'll get an error saying that there is a type error. But if I give this, even if I convert 1 into a string, I'll get the combined output. So here the type, because of the type mismatch, I'm getting error. We'll try to handle this error using a script. For that, I'll create a file here. Exempt.py. So here, first what we need to do was try, then I'll copy the same statement from here. I'll give print. Output is plus y. If we get an error, except, so error, if the error is type error, we'll give type error here. Print. Not a string. We'll get a message called saying not a string. I'll save the script. We'll try to execute it. Python. Yeah, it is not a string. But if I change this to a string, the number 1 to a string, I'll get the output, the combined output, n+1. Now another error will create. I'll add another variable called c here. Now if we try to execute the script again, I'm getting another error called name error because c is not defined. So we can handle it in two ways, multiple ways we can handle. So one way is you can handle it in a generic way, saying that unknown error. So if we give it in this way, any error which comes, it will say any error other than type error, it will say unknown error. We are getting unknown error now. To handle this particular case, specific case, we'll give name error and we'll mention variable is not defined. And save the script. Now, if we execute, so we're getting the message saying variable is not defined. Now we'll define the variable on top. C equals to. Now we'll try to execute. Then we'll get a combined output. If you're not defining C, we'll get variable is not defined. And if type is not matching, then we'll get a type error, not a string. So this is one of the simple script for explaining how to handle the exceptions. Now we'll move on to NetMiko exception. To handle device unreachable error, we'll look into our NetMiko document and the same error we are getting. So what we need to do, we need to import this into our script. From netmiko.ssh exception, import netmiko timeout exception, and here we need to give try. We execute the connect handler. Then once we run connect handler, if we get exception, NetMiko timeout exception, print device not reachable, any message you can give here. We'll try to execute the script again. The error is because we haven't given continue in the script. We'll give continue here. We'll execute again. Yeah, we're getting the message saying that device not reachable. Then it is trying to connect to another device. We had configured 10 and 11. We'll format the text in a better way. Slash n, we'll add plus. We'll do the strip function. In one of the previous video, I have explained about the string methods. There I have explained about strip. It removes the additional slash n line from the output. We'll execute it. Yeah, connecting to the device. Device not reachable, connecting to another device. And it can execute the command. Now we'll try to handle another error. This is console of my router. What we'll do, we'll change the password in the script, and we'll make an unauthorized error. Yeah, so here we are getting an authentication exception, so we'll handle that error now. Copy this, paste it. Then NetMiko authentication exception. We'll copy the same syntax. We'll say authentication failure. Now we'll try to execute the script again. Yeah, we're getting the message authentication failure. Now we'll change the password to the original one. Then now we'll disable SSH on one of the device. So for that, line VTY 0 to 4, transport input none. Now we'll try to execute again. Yeah, from the device 10 we are getting another SSH exception, so we'll handle that now. For that, we'll copy this, import, from parameter.ssh exception, import ssh exception. We'll give a message saying that make sure SSH is enabled. Now we'll try to execute the script. Yeah. We're getting message saying then make sure SSH is enabled, then it is continuing with another device. So similarly, all the errors you will be able to handle using this. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand how to handle exceptions like device not reachable and authentication error using NetMiko. In the next video, we'll see how to SSH to multiple devices using multiple files. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.